हेलो, आई होप यू ऑल कैन हियर मी। कैन यू ऑल हियर मी? हेलो, हेलो ऑल। ओ ओके 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 दिस इज़ फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम आई एम कमिंग लाइव, सो आई एम लिटिल अनकम्फर्टेबल। सो नमस्ते भरत शास्त्री, हाउ आर यू? सत्यव्रता राउत, यस ओके। सो व्हाइल टॉकिंग अबाउट एस्ट्रोलॉजी, सी वी ऑल आर बिलीवर ऑफ एस्ट्रोलॉजी, राइट? सो व्हेन, हाय आदित्य, सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट एस्ट्रोलॉजी एंड व्हेन वी गो टू एनी बडी टू शो अवर चार्ट ऑल्सो, बिफोर गोइंग एंड इवन इफ यू आर नॉट इन टू एस्ट्रोलॉजी, यू मस्ट नो दैट यू हैव टू सी द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ योर असेंडेंट लॉर्ड इन योर चार्ट। दैट मीन्स यू हैव टू सी द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ लग्नेश इन योर चार्ट, ओके? सो इफ इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द स्ट्रांगनेस एंड स्ट्रेंथनेस ऑफ लग्नेश इन योर चार्ट, दैट विल डिफाइन द ट्रू नेचर एंड ट्रू कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ यू। Unless and until your Lagnesh is strong, your ascendant lord is strong in your chart, you won't be able to get the possible fruits. Okay? Astrology and free will. This is very vast topic. Somebody asked me about the earth signs. This is a very basic question, but I will tell you all. That there are 12 bhavas in a chart, okay? So if we say, if we take a nature's chart, if we take Kalpurush Kundali, the first sign is of Mesha, that is Aries, so that is a Agni Tattva, and second sign is of Taurus, which is a Prithvi Tattva Rashi. So 2, 6, and 10, these three Rashis are earthy signs, that is Taurus, Virgo and Capricorn. All these three Rashis are earthy sign, so you have to keep that in mind. And along with that, these are also in Hindi is called as Prithvi Tattva Rashi. Whoever are having their Lagnesh in movable sign or Chara Rashi, like 1, 4, 7, 10 or 1, 4, in Chara Rashi any Lagnesh is placed, that time these people cannot sit at one place for a longer time. They always try to do some or other thing always, you know. Means and first thing, you if your Lagnesh, if your ascendant is in Chara Rashi and in placed in courage house, that is in third house, so that time to you will never sit at one place. Always you want to do something. You will not sit idle. Same way, if your Lagnesh ascendant lord is in Prithvi Tattva Rashi, that is fixed sign or earthy sign, so you are a stable personality. You think 100 times before taking any decision. Same way, if your Lagnesh, your ascendant lord is in Vayu Tattva Rashi, that time, see, three basic categories, then again four categories. You should know everything. Chara Rashi are 1, 4, 7, 10. Dvi Swabhav Rashi are 3, 6, 9, 12. So you should not mix all these things together. Somebody asked me about no marriage combinations. Very simple combination one has to see in the chart. You just see that if you are a male person, you see the position of Venus in your chart, where your Venus is placed, whether it is afflicted with any Papa planet, your Venus again you see your seventh lord, if it is afflicted in your seventh house also, or it is aspecting your seventh lord or aspecting your seventh house, you have to see that. Again, if Saturn is placed in your seventh house along with Mars, it may give late marriages. Mars and Saturn placed in 12th house in the chart, again it will give late marriage. Mars and Saturn, these two planets plays very important role. If you are a female, you have to see the position of Mars and Jupiter in your chart. See, Jupiter is the main planet. Jupiter is karaka for everything, all auspicious things. So that is but obvious, we have to consider Jupiter. We should take it in mind only that Jupiter should be considered along with all these other planets, you know. So no, I will not say no marriage, that it can be late marriage. Again, if there is a combination of Saturn and Mercury in your seventh house, in your sixth house, then also many a times late marriage can happen. Many a times I have observed in many charts that people having exalted Jupiter aspecting seventh lord are having late marriages in their life. Even people having Saturn and Rahu placed in the sixth house, which is a 12th house from seventh house, have late marriages. Hi Sheila Sutar, my Uranus Neptune Saturn retrograde in 11th house. I cannot see. Okay. My Uranus Neptune Saturn retrograde in 11th house, aspected by Mars in 5th house. I am Aquarius ascendant, as current transit of Saturn is same in any chart. See, at present for Aquarius people, this transit Saturn will go very good. You just see the fruits from the February 2018. Really, Sheila, it will be very fruitful to you people, whoever are having Aquarius ascendant and Sagittarius sign, this will be very fruitful for you people. How does Bhav Chalit chart alter interpretation? Yes, Bhav Chalit chart may alter the interpretation. If in Bhav Chalit chart any particular planet goes in the another house, you have to consider that house Karakatva also along with it. So it really plays very important role. What is the result of combust Mercury in 12th house in what is the result of combust Mercury in 12th house in Sagittarius Lagna? So that will be combust Mercury in your Scorpio. Okay, but with what it is combust? It is combust with Surya. Or again, any other planet is there, let me know that. Even though if it is combust, see, Mercury and Venus, both planets do not give much result about, specifically I will talk about Mercury, because Mercury grasps the characteristics and features of all the planets it is placed with, you know. So even though it is combust or Vakri also, it will absorb the features of the planet it is placed with. But it will give good fruits if it is a combust Mercury in 12th house. You may be having forgetful nature, or while signing any particular papers, you have to take care. What is the result of, I saw that. Is KP method is also good as compared to Vedic method? Nikhil Jain. KP method for particular event, specific event you can go for, but KP method is the outcome of Vedic only, so there is no question of asking this query. So Vedic is the root of everything, no matter you follow anything. 11th house lord aspect 11th lord, very good. If 11th house lord is aspected by its own lord, it will enhance and it will make stronger the effect of that 11th house also and 5th house also, or wherever it is placed with. Hello ma'am, what if, hi Suman Rahman, what if 7th lord Jupiter exalted and aspect 7th house? सेवेंथ लॉर्ड जुपिटर एग्जॉल्टेड, ओके, दैट मीन्स यू आर हैविंग केप्रिकॉन लग्न, राइट, एंड इट इज एस्पेक्टिंग सेवेंथ हाउस, डोमिनेटिंग नेचर ऑफ स्पाउस इज एक्सपेक्टेड हियर, योर मे बी लेट मैरिज, योर स्पाउस विल बी फॉन्ड ऑफ गिविंग एडवाइजेस एवरी नाउ एंड देन, गुड लुकिंग एंड वेरी लर्न्ड पर्सन ऑल्सो योर स्पाउस मे बी. हियर यू शुड नॉट गो फॉर पार्टनरशिप बिजनेस, आई विल एडवाइज यू दैट इफ एट ऑल सैटर्न इज ऑल्सो एस्पेक्टिंग योर सेवेंथ लॉर्ड और सेवेंथ हाउस. येस, नक्षत्र प्रेडिक्शन प्लेज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. वी हैव टू टेक ईच नक्षत्र, ईच प्लैनेट नक्षत्र, इट्स significance, and then we have to predict. For example, if anybody is having moon in Rahu Nakshatra, even though if this moon is placed in Tula Rashi, say Libra, and it is in Swati Nakshatra, so this moon will grasp the maximum energy from this Swati Nakshatra, and based on that only you have to predictor chart. Nakshatra is the soul of prediction. I have Jupiter and Sun in Cancer ascendant and Saturn moon in 7th house. Saturn moon in 7th house and Sun in Lagna. Okay, so that is Capricorn, Saturn and moon in your 7th house. And Jupiter and Sun in Cancer. See, in Cancer ascendant, Mars is the Yogkarak planet. And your, I can't see the query properly. Where it has gone? It is so fast. Yes, I teach Jyotish Madhavi. And I will be declaring very soon, maybe from the first week of June, I am going to start online classes. Pranay Dhokade, kashe ahat tumhi, I hope you are Maharashtrian. Sixth Lord of Rashi, debilitated in 6th house of Navmansha. First you see that this debilitation in your 6th house is in which Rashi, and that Rashi where it is placed in your natal chart, so it will give fruits according to the Rashi of natal chart rather than of Navmansha chart. How does Bhavchalit chart after I already explained about it. Deep Ghosh, my Mars is in Tula Rashi. Suman, actually I am not able to. All the comments are jumbling between each other, so I am not able to read it properly. Tejashri, hi, how are you? Okay, what difference does it make if planet position changes in Bhavchalit chart? It doesn't make a very big difference. Only thing in Bhavchalit for particular event, you have to consider that Bhavchalit placed planet and then see the chart. But you should not stop seeing the natal chart. Debilitated Venus in Navmansha, Binod. Now first see the, even though you have debilitated Venus in Navmansha chart, that is in Virgo, but see its strength in your natal chart where it is placed. So even though in your natal chart, if your Venus is in good position, you should not worry much about it. So first check the strength in natal chart and then see it in Navmansha chart. Hello Dhidifai, please explain a bit about Badhak sign and Mandi with it. Thank you so much. You always appreciate my videos. I would like to thank you here. Thank you Dhidifai, I don't know your real name, but thank you very much. You are always a supporting supporting pillar, I should say. Okay, about Badhak planet, see Badhak theory is very vast, but whenever Mandi is a slow process, Mandi acts like a Saturn only because it is a Upagraha of Saturn. So Mandi wherever placed in the chart, no matter with any planet or without any planet, it will definitely deteriorate the fruit of that house. Now again Badhaka. So Badhak planet, first of all, you should consider for health issues. First of all, whenever Dasha, Antardasha of your Badhakesh comes, that time you have to first see the health aspect, and then the second result of it is that some obstacles are seen in your working progress, you know, because of this Badhaka planet. Now, as everybody know that for Chara Rashi, for 1, 4, 7, 10, Badhaka planet will be 11th Lord. Okay, I hope everybody knows that. It has stopped, I think. I can't see. If Kama signs powerful, what effects on our... it's a half message. What if Venus is combust in 4th house in Mesh Lagna? That is in Moon Karak Bhava, Venus. It gives very good and lavish house, but you know, some or other things are missing. Many a times you have to be away from your sisters, away from your mother. It gives certain fruits there. It's very difficult to go live, you know, it's jumbling all the things. Maybe this is the first time I am. Juhi Gupta, I'm not skipping your query, dear, but I'm on my mobile. So I'm not able to see your query actually. Still, after this video, I will try to answer it. Hi Sunili ji, I am from Australia. So how can I learn astrology from you? Yeah, from the first week of June, I am going to start my basic classes, basic to advanced. So all of you can join it. I will very soon declare it on YouTube also, the dates and all that. So you all may join it there. I am Leo ascendant, Jupiter and Venus in first house. Oh, you are a artistic and creative personality. Jupiter and Venus, you are a very good presenter. I mean to say, you can present the things very nicely. If you want to talk somewhere, you can convince the people very nicely. This quality is very good in you. And Saturn in Capricorn in Uttarashada Nakshatra of Sun. Okay, so you have to make good relations with elderly people, with your father, and worship Lord Shiva always. Exalted and combust Venus conjunct Sun for Aquarius ascendant, will it be a Badhakesh in its Dasha? Exalted combust Venus in Aquarius. Venus is a Yog Karaka planet for Aquarius ascendant, so definitely it will deteriorate, or it will lessen the bad fruits even if its Dasha, Antar Dasha come. For a best Pankaj Lalwani ji, for best result, you just go through the dasha which you have already passed, and you see the antar dasha of Venus in that certain periods, how was it. So you can just correlate that dashas, and you will come to know the result out of it, how your this Venus dasha will go, because you have to see the other aspect also in the chart. But as per my views, it will not go bad, it will go good, because it will be a second Lord as exalted planet in Meena Rashi, so and in Dhana Bhava. So money wise it will definitely give you very good fruits. You can see some transformations, some new venture also you can start, or you can join some new work also. Yeah, Tejashree, you are always welcome, come. Okay, retrograde Saturn aspecting Lagnesh from 8th house. Retrograde Saturn aspecting Lagnesh from 8th house. Okay. एर्थ हाउस इज लॉन्जिटिविटी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल. इवन दो इट इज रेट्रो, जस्ट सी द सूर्य पोजिशन इन योर चार्ट एंड हाउ योर असेंडेंट लॉर्ड इज विथ सन, सो दैट यू कैन डिसाइड द ओवरऑल पोजिशन एंड इन विच भावा दिस सैटर्न इज aspecting the Lagnesh, means third aspect, seventh aspect or tenth aspect, you have to consider the aspect also. Karthik, what please ma'am, I didn't get your any message. Okay, Suman, you had Virgo Lagna you said. I read somebody else's I think comment in your comment also, everything is coming in jumbling way, many all two, three, four. Oh, okay. For Prashna Kundali, you have to follow moon calendar, and for particular event, you can follow sun calendar. Surya Kundali in routine, whenever I see the chart, I always see from Chandra Kundali, from Surya Kundali and Rahu Kundali also I follow. Mars in how functional malefic affects Maharashtra. Okay, we will talk on Monday in astrology sometime, but nowadays Maharashtra is in full form. So, it will not affect much to us people in Maharashtra. Some good achievements very soon. We are going to, technologically Maharashtra will go very ahead, very fast process, you can see. Second thing, some epidemics may appear within these 2 months in Maharashtra, that is also can be seen. Third house Saturn in Sagittarius, Ambuj Sharma. Third house Saturn in Sagittarius and ninth house and ninth house Mars in Gemini with Saturn retro. Third house Saturn in Sagittarius, okay, in Tula Lagna. Okay, the Saturn is retro. Okay, it is aspecting Mars. Okay, Saturn and Mars, are you into some technical work? So you have to take care at present, because in Sagittarius now Saturn is already transiting over your Saturn. So you have to just I will advise you one thing. See, your comment has gone somewhere now. I will advise you only one thing. Here, rather than hearing the prediction, just make your ascendant lord, that is Venus, very strong over here. So you, whatever hurdles you are facing at present for the Bhagyode, means you are trying to achieve some work but it is not happening in your case. I could just guess that by giving the position of planets which you have given. So it can be little difficult for you. So just make Lagnesh strong, that is a Venus. Just chant any Devi mantra every day at least for 10 minutes. You will really get good fruits. You will start getting the fruits within these 15 days. And just let me know. Pushkar Navmansha, please Panda Jazin ji, hello, please explain about Pushkar Navmansha. Okay, I will take one special session on Pushkar Navmansha, because here it won't be able, it won't be I think advisable to explain about Pushkar Navmansha, but in short I will say that whoever are having their planets in Pushkar Navmansha, even if these planets are not having very good strength or not having or not placed in Karak Bhava in your natal chart, still if they are in Pushkar Navmansha, they will definitely fruit you very good, even though they are not functional benefic planet in your chart. I will definitely take Pushkar now, Mansha. Thank you for asking this. Okay. Leo girl on board. Wow. So nice names you keep. Okay. Hi, Leo girl. So you are Leo sign. Ma'am, what is the result if 11th Lord Mercury is combust and placed in 9th with Sun? Okay. Jupiter in 7. Are now where your comment has gone? How it is going? This is very difficult. Okay, I will just stop. Achha, I am seeing your video with KRS and I really feel great. You traveling to US, so we'll be seeing you go to. Yeah, I am hoping to travel there, but let's see. My visa has not come yet. So let's see. I am just planning to go there. Sankara Subramaniam, Punarvasu, Rahu in 7th house. Okay. Punarvasu, Rahu. Oh, so whether it is in Cancer or it is in Gemini. 7th Lord Moon. It has gone, your comment. I can't see very faint comments are coming. I am not able to read it properly. Same comments. Anyways, okay, I will finish it here because I have got some poor connection also. I am getting some message from my net connection. I think something is wrong over there, so I will take leave of all of you. Maybe I was jumbling somewhere here or there because it is very difficult to see the comments also, and constantly all the comments are coming and I am on my mobile. So it was very nice seeing you all, and God bless you all. Thank you so very much. Bye-bye. Take care. See you soon.